It's Cooking with John.
Hey everybody, how you doing today? I've been taking a break from Cooking with John because I've been doing other things. And anybody that's subscribed to my channel knows that I do a lot of things. There's the John Show, there's the mime skits, there's Truth About Science. And then, of course, I'm an artist and a musician, and so I've just been doing a lot of different things. But then I've also been working on the house, too. But anyway, today I'm going to attempt to make homemade sweet and sour shrimp. Now, there's a couple different ways to prep your shrimp. One of the ways to peel shrimp is to grab it by the legs. Grab it by the legs, and you rip the legs away and around the back of the shrimp. Like that. Now, and if you're going to keep the tail on, you can do that. But I'm not going to keep the tail on because these are small shrimp. So I'm going to, then what I do is I make a vertical press right there and it kind of breaks the shell and allows some air to get in so you can pull out the tail. Another way to clean shrimp, if they're bigger shrimp and you're going to peel and devein them at the same time, you take a knife and you run it straight up the back like this, and this will fillet it at the same time too. But I don't plan on filleting all these. And then you can peel it out this way, which is kind of the opposite way. But that's just an example, and I'm not gonna do that to these shrimp. So I just wanted to show you two ways to clean your shrimp. As far as your shrimp shells are concerned, wrap them up tight in some plastic and get rid of them because they will stink. In fact, you might even want to rinse them off before you wrap them up. I'm going to continue to peel these up. This is going to take a little while. So I'll get back to you in a minute. Now, when I worked at Arctic Seafood, I cleaned a lot of shrimp. It's funny because I got a bag of some breading. Had been in storage for a while. It's golden dipped breading, which is really good stuff. I'm looking at the bag, and price was $9.99, and it was in my handwriting. And I looked, and it was from 2012, this is 2020 now. It's 8 years ago, and that's what the last time I worked at Arctic Seafood, and it's crazy, man, because I used it anyway. It's delicious. It's still great, man. I used it another time since then, too. So that stuff's indestructible, man. If it's stored properly. They found rice in the Pharaoh's tombs that they planted, and it grew. Another thing about shrimp, too. I'll use one of these bigger ones to show you. If you want to devein the shrimp after you peeled it, use the same way with the knife. Shrimp that are really small, it really doesn't matter. You just run it from the front to the back like that. Okay? If they're big enough, you can hold them right over your finger like this. And it just pulls the vein right out. Now, I was thinking about how am I going to make sweet and sour sauce? When I looked online, I love the cherry sauce, or at least I thought it was cherry sauce, right? So it turns out that the sweet and sour sauce is actually just sugar and cornstarch and red food coloring, basically. Oh, yeah, vinegar. There's vinegar in it. That's about it. I thought, that's not cool. And I don't have any cornstarch. And I really wanted cherry sauce. And I'm thinking, what can I do? I don't have anything to thicken it with, right? And, I've been planning on making a cherry pie. And some of the thick cherry pie filling is what I'm going to use to add with some vinegar to make some sweet and sour sauce. So, experiment day again. We'll see how that comes out. I love trying new stuff. Can't be afraid to try new stuff, man. That's how things get invented. All right, you know what? While I finish this up, let's go to a commercial. That's right, I'm going to start running some commercials with this. But you'll see why. Anyway, go on. See you back here in a minute.
If you haven't been watching The John Show, this is what you've been missing.
There's 14 million of us live together. You'd think somebody would help me.
Where are our shirts? I threw them over the hill. There's dancing. Music.
Bad feel cutie, what have you done? Baby, don't do it.
And even educational bits.
So.
Tips for teens. Dialing a rotary phone. Zany fun.
Don't record. Hello?
Take those glasses off. You look ridiculous.
Billy Astro, space hero.
What did the Buddhist say to the hot dog vendor? Make me one with everything.
What are you waiting for? Hurry to the link and catch The John Show. Don't miss another episode.
Now it's time for The John Show. So come on door, everybody. Sit down, shut up, and watch.
All right, you're back, huh? Okay, I'm almost done with these. And then I got to make some batter. But first, I'm going to go ahead and make the sweet and sour sauce, which is going to work out perfect because I'm planning on making a cherry pie today, too. But that's going to be a different show. So these are very tiny shrimp. This is, you know, going to be a more of an appetizer than anything. These are raw shrimp. If you're going to be cooking something like this, you want raw shrimp. All right, there we go. There's some shrimp to cook. So I don't need a lot of this cherry pie filling. I don't need a lot of sweet and sour sauce. So I'm going to try to cook it. You're supposed to cook it a little bit. The reason I'm using the pie filling is because it's naturally thick. I mean, look at it. That's what I needed. I don't have the cornstarch. And I don't want red colored sugar water. I want cherry sauce. So I am making sweet and sour cherry sauce for my tempura battered shrimp. That should be plenty. The other ingredient we need is some vinegar. I don't know how much. Like I say, this is an experiment again. Let's try that. I'm going to mix that together. I'm going to taste it, and then I'm going to pop it in the microwave for a minute. It looks great. Wow. I wonder if I should even cook it. I'm not even going to bother cooking it. Okay, this is going in a pie later. Let's make some tempura batter. All right, I do not need a lot of tempura batter either. Some flour. That's plenty, probably. Baking powder. Do not use baking soda because we're going to use vinegar. So you don't want to mix vinegar and baking soda. It's just going to foam up and be done with it. So you make sure it's baking powder that you're using. Baking powder. I'm going to have to get some water. I already got my oil preheated. Here's a little bit of vinegar. And some water. You want to get a consistency like a only slightly thick fluid. Like a very thin batter. Actually, that looks pretty good. I'm gonna pop in the shrimp. I'm gonna stir them up good. And then I'm gonna pluck them out a little bit at a time and throw them into the oil. Oh boy. So let's go to the stove. You're here too long. Oh boy, sweet and sour shrimp. Yeah, these should probably be stuck together. That's all right. I don't care. I ain't no restaurant. I cook for me. Okay, that's all the shrimp. Gonna get this out the way. Let these cook for a while. I'm gonna stir these around a bit. Okay, they're cooking up nice. Now, with shrimp this size, you go with raw. Start with raw, because they're gonna cook fast. But if you're gonna do sweet and sour pork or sweet and sour chicken, I would suggest you use pre-cooked pork or chicken. So, but these are getting done very quickly. But seafood's like that. Seafood cooks quick. Anyway, there you go. Tempura shrimp. Yeah, I'm gonna have homemade sweet and sour shrimp. Yay! I just want these to brown up a little longer, and I'll take them out. Yeah. Come on. Put them over here on that paper towel. And they're gonna be hot. No doubt. And they're probably still cooking inside. So, I would wait for a minute. All right. They sure look good. Now, okay, I'm going to, and here, look at the consistency of this. See, that's just, it's perfect. It's just right. Okay, I'm going to attempt to use this. These are not actual chopsticks. These are meat skewers. Okay, here we go. Dip it in the sweet and sour sauce. Fantastic. Mmm. That's so good. That was easy. I can't believe it. I wonder if I knew who ever thought of using cherry pie filling. So good, man. Mmm. Sweet and sour shrimp. Try this at home. You'll like it. Little history about chopsticks. First of all, these are meat skewers. Don't use dowel rods. They're too big. Don't use insect sticks because they taste funny. You might think they're fancy and all that, but fact be known, the people of China were so poor at that time, during the time that they started using chopsticks, because they couldn't afford utensils, so they used chopsticks. I mean, that's why they built their homes out of paper and stuff. Sure wasn't to be artistic. Tell you one thing for sure. China is a wonderful culture filled with wonderful art, music, and food. So there you have it. Oh, by the way, if you like this, subscribe to my channel. There's a lot more than Cooking with John. There's the John Show. There's the mime skits. There's my music videos. There's the truth about science. And there's just a lot of stuff. I do a lot of different things. So subscribe to my channel and share me with your friends. And thanks for watching. And I'll catch you on the next show. Bye. Mmm, so good.